is, it's fatiguing. You're watching, I have something to say.
I love talk shows.
The hell is going on? The baby in the two, by the time we get a new Scandal episode.
Are you guys following the ratchet news that is busting the top of Atlanta?
Basketball Live, see you.
Paparazzi go hard.
Like, just to get you to turn around and look at them, they will say anything.
Relate success when it comes to other black people to the top.
I don't debate religion, politics, or Jay-Z.
Kelly Rowland could have kept her dirty laundry in a hamper.
And Beyonce is awesome. I'm calling y'all haters. No shade to R&B divas, but it is what it is. Come on, y'all here.
You and the girl just went ahead and put bite. I recommend the place.
Hey guys, this is Tima Sharif and thanks for watching I Have Something to Say. Today I'm at Sin Sin. It's in Chestnut Hill on Germantown. I believe it's called Pike once you hit a certain part. So I'm going to say Germantown Pike. It's an Asian restaurant that I used to frequent when I lived in the area. So no, this is not a new place for me. It's an oldie but goodie. And of course I'm always hoping that it's the same. I really love their crab fried rice. So yeah, I already know what I'm getting. The lump crab fried rice is awesome. Awesome, awesome. I'm almost 100% sure it's going to be a good time. But we'll see. So let's start off talking about Kim and Kanye. Today's supposed to be the big day over in Florence. They're getting married. It's on and popping. It's going down in Florence on today. I mean, overall, I guess you gotta be happy about love. So I'm happy for them. I'm just concerned for Kanye, as I will be until I have no reason to be concerned for Kanye. I was concerned for Jay-Z when he first got with Beyonce. Very concerned. I wanted to make sure he was okay. And I've always been a slight fan of Kanye West, and I kind of lost it for him when I saw that he was taking Kim Kardashian seriously, because I just didn't think anybody would. I wasn't here for the relationship, but I ain't gonna hate on the... I mean, they're getting married today. I'm pretty sure they're all excited, and I really am, like, kind of happy for him. Dang, how can you be kind of happy for him? But I am, I'm kind of happy for him. Whatever, to each his own. And I just hope everything goes well, and I do hope that Jay-Z is there as his best man, because Kanye West doesn't have his mom, and I know that he and Jay-Z's relationship is authentic, and it would probably mean the world to him to have a real best friend standing up with him on today. So I just hope that Jay-Z really did make it. It doesn't matter if Beyonce makes it or not. To me, I kind of wanted her not to come, just because Kim and them are so just messy. But I do hope that Jay-Z could be there today. Now, one thing that got on my nerves this week about those damn Kardashians, though, is the amount of pictures they felt necessary to post, because they were either on their way to Paris or in Paris. We all know that they are not, you know how you say you can tell somebody never had nothing. No, they've been to Greece, they've been to Rome, Dubai, everywhere. Why not? They was acting like niggas in Paris. Every little step. I was like, shut up and stop posting all them damn pictures. Stop acting like you never been anywhere. How should they were acting like they never been anywhere? And I guess they're excited for the wedding. But I think it was overkill. All them damn pictures, they was getting on my nerves. It was just like, for what? Chill. I'm gonna leave the Kardashians alone for now and move on to another reality star, I guess, and that's Apollo Nilda from The Real Housewives of Atlanta, Phaedra's husband. Apollo is in all kinds of trouble, facing jail time. Basically, from what I've been reading, he is going to jail soon for fraud. And he's been speaking out, doing interviews, and in one of the interviews, he mentioned that he expects Phaedra to wait for him. And a lot of people went off like, what is she supposed to be, like a ride or die chick? She don't have to wait for him, blah, blah, blah. But what I was looking into was, I would say the wording that he used. He said, give me one second, I'm gonna say it. This is what he said. He said, I think Phaedra, in a perfect world, should be supportive as a wife should be. But if she chooses to derail from the plan, that's where I put my period. I look at it like this. I don't think there's any way in hell that Apollo was doing all that mess and Phaedra wasn't privy to it. Phaedra is very, very smart. Go ahead and do what you do, but I'm not getting involved. his comment about derailing from the plan is, okay, well, if see, now I'm in trouble, but you need to chill because we was in this together. Yeah, we kept your name out of it. There's no way that you can get in trouble for it. However, you should wait for me because I was doing this for us. Period. It ain't about no being right now, chick. We did for your man. No, I do not think Phaedra was ignorant to that mess that Apollo was into. And as long as she could benefit from it, she did. She's all about a dollar. We see that. Business after business. I mean, I ain't hating on. I love a good hustler. I love a good hustle. However, she wasn't ignorant to what Apollo was doing. And that is why he expects her to chill until he comes home. Period. Just one more thing about reality TV. I just want to give a shout out to Tracy Braxton, Tanisha from Bad Girls Club, and J-Row from Jersey Shore for being on Marriage Boot Camp. Hunting. Hunt. Hey. But I don't know, it just went off. Somehow I watched this crazy. Probably Bad Girls Club, because I love it. Lord. Anyway, when that went off and I saw Tracy crying and Tanisha pissed off at somebody and then J-Wow just sitting on the couch, I said, baby, the combination. I mean, get money, y'all. Get it. I'm getting them little reality show checks. I wonder what if I could ever be on a reality show. Give me a little couple dollars. Do that, y'all. Marriage Boot Camp. Yeah. Do you know what else was interesting to me this week? When Tori Hart did her interview with Roxy this week, a lot of people gave her a hard time saying she needs to get over Kevin Hart and, you know, it's been 6 years, move on, she's still bitter. And for some reason, here I am again, seeing it from another angle. I do think she has moved on. She's accepted it. She said it in the interview. She has a boyfriend. He said it in his Twitter rant. She has someone now. If she hadn't moved on, she would still be single, peeking through the window at him and Nico because it can't be over. So I think she has moved on. I believe she answered a question. She was asked a question regarding their breakup, the divorce, what caused it, and she was honest. And then everybody blamed her. Oh, don't let him live in your head rent-free. Kick him out. She did. Wasn't she on his show? He got her come on as a guest, you know, on his show. Their relationship is fine. To me, Tori was just being honest in her answer, and she caught a bad rap for that. I think that what we sometimes think we want is the politically correct answer, like, oh, you know, that was a long time ago, and we're both over it now. I have someone, he has someone, and it's the past. If she would have said that, everybody would like, please, she knows more to that story. So she's honest, and now she's caught up. She's not over. Even Kevin was like, you know, put her business out there in regards to how much she has to pay her monthly for alimony and things like that. He's pissed off because she told the truth. You know what I mean? And if you ask me, still, when her feelings resurface, it does not always mean that you still want that person. She was asked a question. She was honest in her answer. And those feelings probably did resurface. That was her husband. Her children's father, they were together for years. She was with him from the beginning. And if Nico was a whole bag and was cheating with him and she got the spot, she should kind of still feel some type of way, just a little bit. And then you get over it, you move on, you go fry chicken and stuff and get dinner together. You know what I mean? It's okay to revisit. She had to revisit. She was in an interview. She was asked a question and she was honest in her answer. But we can't say that too much about everyone. So, I mean, leave her alone. Leave her alone. Team Kevin, because I don't even think about either one of them. It was just definitely the going on this week. I had to mention it, and I just think that she caught a bad rap for being honest. I do think that Kevin was cheating with Nico and other girls, and then he got caught up to Nico. And it's cool, get caught up. I remember when he used to reference her as his rib earlier in the relationship. I used to be like, damn, how does his wife feel? Like, how should he become your rib? Like, I was your wife, I wasn't your rib, but you got a lot of ribs. You just replace your ribs, I don't know. But that used to bother me a little bit in the beginning. And like I said, kudos to Tori for answering honestly. And shout out to everybody talking about somebody bitter. Shut up. You bitter. And moving on to more current events, I guess I will call it. I was a little bothered by Mark Cuban this past week and his comments, more racist comments about how he people cross the street if a black guy or a black person with a hood was on the same side as him. And then he tried to like make it okay by saying even if it was like a white guy with a trench coat, he would have done the same thing. And then he had to come back and apologize to Trayvon Martin's parents because that was a very insensitive remark, being as though Trayvon Martin wasn't that long ago. So he had to come back and apologize and blah, blah, blah. It was newsworthy, of course. Everyone was talking about it. The biggest problem I had with people like Mark Cuban during these interviews is, why are you sharing conversations that you might have at home with your family or at the golf course with your buddies on in interviews? Like, who asked you? Or not even who asked you, because maybe I'm not going to front like I know what the question was. All I want to know is, why didn't you give the politically correct answer in this situation? Why would you say that during an interview? Why? Say that to your wife at night when y'all, you know, yeah, honey, I'm sorry. What are you saying in an interview for? Now you gotta come back and, did you feel like being relevant this week? If I say that, I'll make front page. Is that what happened? Because I don't get it. I don't get it. You're grown. You're a full grown man. So you're not a child. You're not some newbie to the game that still needs a publicist. This is stupid to me. Keep your private talk private. Somebody asked you something that's risque during an interview, answer it so that you're not getting into trouble. Unless you wanted to get into trouble. So you can be talked about like Donald Sterling and all the rest of them. Maybe that was it. I'm putting them cash on these days. So stupid. Shout out to Pennsylvania for overturning the ban on gay marriage. It was a long time coming. I mean, people get over it. Religious folk, stick to your own beliefs and convictions and mind your business. Y'all don't have a heaven or a hell to put nobody in. Put your picket signs down, take it behind the church, pay your tithes, and just go ahead. Mind your business. Mind your business. I'm happy for them. I understand the need for it in the majority of cases. I've heard of some horror stories where long life partners have been left, you know, like in really horrible situations when sudden death may come and like the family just comes and basically takes over and just doesn't even treat them as if they were significant in that other person's life because there's nothing legally binding and they're just not treated correctly. And overall, they really do love each other. The love is genuine. Just watching some of the couples on the news made me happy. Like, I mean, just like I said about Kim and Kanye, how could you play on love? I mean, the other part of it, in regards to God and what the Bible says and what's right and what's wrong regarding sex, I'm not here for that part of it, but I'm glad that PA finally got on the ball. And just, let it go ahead. Everybody has a right to their opinion, but yeah, there's nothing you can do about it. It ain't gonna change, so whatever, you're wasting your time. So they announced the Made in America lineup for Philly. Kanye's coming, Pharrell's coming, a lot of other people coming. I ain't coming. I ain't go last year. I ain't go the year before. And I'm not going this year. Y'all got that, hunting. Listen, at least at Citizens Bank Park, I'll have a seat, you know. Y'all standing up amongst each other with all that mess. Hot. Cousin. Have fun. You know what? I almost forgot to talk about Mace, the rapper from back in the P. Diddy days. Did I have to say that? Anyway, he supposedly kicked his wife out the church because she was pulled over for driving while under the influence. That's so shady, Mace. You probably be under the influence with her sometimes at home and stuff. Why are you gonna kick her out the church? Shut up, is that one of the transvestites they had? Who was, is his wife the transvestite? Did nobody say he was on the transvestite in Atlanta? Did he marry the transvestite? Because like, she ain't had no kids or nothing yet. Shit, how do you know? Might be the transvestite. You front the transvestite after all she's been through. Alright, guys, so food came. Food was excellent. Simpson has not changed at all. And I was kind of happy because I didn't realize it was lunchtime. And my crab and shrimp fried rice is normally $18. I only had to pay $9.95 today. So I'm a little happy. I'm winning, okay? Anyway, for appetizers, I had the crab and shrimp spring roll and the Thai chicken. Both were really good. Already had the spring rolls before. Perfect. The Thai chicken was something new for me. The sauce was really good. Kind of gave me a curry feeling to it. And then they kind of burnt it a little bit. It was like charred, like a grill thing going on. And that was excellent. It was so damp. That was good. That was good. So let's move on to lunch because it's kind of early and that's what we ordered. That's why it wasn't full price. Yeah. For lunch, I had the crab and shrimp fried rice. As I stated earlier, it was so good years ago, and it's still so damn good. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it because it's lump crab meat in there, nice size shrimp, and the meat and the rice is actually fried. I went to an Asian place down on Spring Garden, I forget the name of it, and everyone was boasting about their lump crab meat fried rice, and when I got home, my rice was white. Okay? And I had to pull out my wok and do some things in my kitchen that got paid. I wasn't right about that to me, but since then, there was fried rice, like it's supposed to be, okay? And it was really good. So you should come for that. And then I also tried the sake chicken. Now, it's listed as being extra spicy with mixed veggies. And it's spicy, but I don't know about the extra unless I just have a different type of palate because I love spicy. It just didn't affect me at all, but it was good. It was excellent. And there, and I got brown rice to go with it. And the brown rice was good. It's not sticky and all. Just, who cares? Just give me some brown rice. Brown rice. Simpson is like an old treasure in the neighborhood. It's been here for years. And everybody I know who comes here is pleased. So if you've never been and you're in the area or feel like driving, come through. Simpson's a good time. I will say what I need to say about the staff, though, because, you know, I mean, it is what it is. I understand the cultural differences, and I guess in these type of settings, when you are dealing with people from another culture who aren't totally ingrained in the way that we are here, I mean, in regards to being in America, there are always going to be communication barriers or issues going on, and a few times I just felt like they were being rude, and I guess you can always say, oh, but you know, yeah, but oh, and what up, but shoot, this is when you want to be. I get it, the differences, and she didn't mean it like that. You know how they are. But when are they not going to be like that? I mean, it's been years. Simpson's been here for years. That was the owner. I'm going to make her the owner. That was the owner. I mean, you were a successful businesswoman, and we still got issues with communicating. When I walk in the store, and you telling me how to get to my seat, and I almost felt like my mind came back. Honey, I said, you know, wait a minute. Okay, that's what I had to tell. Yeah, but I still enjoy myself. You don't want to be bothered. Just get takeout. Yo, we can relieve. After we paid, they came back with these fortune cookies dipped in dark chocolate. Yo, don't take out. Eat, yo, sit here, for real. Sit here and get them fortune cookies. Yo, listen.